And here is the end of Sigmund's story. He was a fierce and great warrior who fought many battles. But one day, an old man came onto the battlefield. Although shadowed by a hood, Sigmund saw a deep... I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we?
I don't like it.
This place feels...
What is this place?
This place feels...
It's...
creepy.
Creepy.
It feels wrong.
It feels strange.
Where is it? Where are we?
Turn back.
This is wrong.
This has to be wrong.
There he is.
There he is.
The light.
Go towards it.
He's in the house.
Find.
He's going in.
He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
The air.
Where's it gone? Keep going.
How do you find it? It's just a trial.
It's just another test.
You just have to solve it, and then you will find him.
Then you will succeed.
It's a test. Like the old warrior trials. Dillian will help me.
Stench of rot. She can almost taste it. Do you smell it? No. Don't worry. Not everyone can. It was a warm spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. But the water. She could taste the rot. But no one else could. She knew something was wrong. Sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing. And they knew that she was not like them.
Now you have to find him.
Quick, get to the house. Get to the house and finish this trial.
It doesn't finish until you get to the house.
Before he disappears, Senua.
You have to get in.
The Northmen speak of a death moon, a light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the death moon appear at a farm, and first the shepherd died, then a guest died, and then the farmhands, and then the farmer and six of his men drowned at sea. That is not the end of it, because the dead return to haunt the living. If you see the death moon, then beware, because there will be death in that house.
found a way.
To climb the tower.
The ladder.
What now?
You can see it. A line to the truth. The bridge.
Genoa! Come to me! Where are you?
I'm here! I'm right here!
Are you in there? Come out if you are.
Where is he? Find him.
You have to find him.
The runes.
Focus.
Focus on the runes.
Focus the runes.
Focus on what comes out.
Delia! They're coming for me!
Dillian, go to him.
Dillian?
Go to him.
Dillian doesn't sound.
He's trying to save you. There it is.
It's close.
It's
close.
Run! It's run! Run!
Close, move away.
Senua, move away.
Let it
go. It is.
Go towards it.
Run.
Focus.
Find it.
Focus. Focus. Run.
Run.
Run now.
Senua.
Where are they, Senua?
Where's Dillian?
Where are you?
Don't let it see you.
Don't get lost.
Don't let it see you.
Come on.
You'll start to burn.
Going. You'll burn.
There it is. Move away.
What should I do?
Where's Dillian?
Where is he?
This is taking too long.
Can you hear him? You're
two
lost.
Two more runes.
You have to find them, Senua.
Where are you? You're lost.
Where are they?
This all looks the same.
The light.
One.
The rune.
Go towards it.
Focus.
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 One more.
To find one more.
Down.
One more.
Down, Senua.
Don't get lost. Find the other symbol. You're lost.
Don't let them look at you.
Where's Dillian?
Where is he?
You've got them.
You have them.
Where's the door?
Find a way out.
Find the gate.
Get out.
Get run.
Out.
Run. Run.
Don't let him look at you.
Don't let it see you. It's coming. Move away. You're lost again.
It's
it is.
It's
run.
Close.
Run. Run now.
Run. It's not safe here. Run.
Send one.
Run.
You don't even have your sword.
You came through the wrong door.
How are you going to fight?
Where's your sword?
How are you going to defend yourself?
What is that creature?
You can't defend yourself.
It's Dillian. Find the creature.
Where's Dillian?
Where are we?
That's not Dillian.
It's not safe. I feel unsafe. Where is it?
I'm Where are you?
It is.
Huh? It's close.
Run! Run now!
Run! It's not safe here. Run!
Send one.
You don't even have your sword.
You came through the wrong door.
How are you going to fight?
Where's your sword?
How are you going to defend yourself?
What is that creature?
You can't defend
yourself. It's Dillian. Find the creature.
Where's Dillian?
Where are we?
I can't find you.
Where is it? I'm not safe. You're dying.
You're lost.
You're dying. This is what death feels like.
Senua! What happened?
They're blaming me for the plague. They say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void. It doesn't make them true.
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I have. You're not a monster.
Without you, this darkness has made me a monster.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong?
What if this is pointless? doing this? What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be lost.
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick. It's just a pointless test.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
You don't know.
It's just their game for you.
You never know which way it's going to go.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin, he was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
Don't go near it.
Don't go there.
Don't go too close.
Don't go to the mask.
You don't know what will happen if you touch it.
You want to see what the mask sees.
Stay back, don't
touch. Where are we?
What is this?
It's the same.
Different.
It's another world. It's lighter.
It's nicer. I like it here. Can
the
we
bridge?
See? It's not broken.
It's fixed.
What happened?
Bridge is fixed.
Let's cross it.
The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death and the gods. Fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her son. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it. What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe.
Dillion.
There he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go.
He disappears.
Dillion, don't lose
him. Where is he?
Where's he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark world.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillion taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear.
Not in this world.
No. Not. Do you remember the way he touched you? Remember, Dillian? What do you remember? Do you remember the sound of his voice? Dillian saved you from them. Do you think she remembers him?
Precious to you.
Where are you taking
him? He's up there. You have to get him. There's a way. There is a way up there. She can do it. You're nearly there.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Huth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Huth says, "I cannot see where Baldur stands. And even if I could see him, I have no weapon." Loki replies, Here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands. And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Baldur. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Baldur is killed. And for this, Hoth is slain.
Your curse has claimed Dillion.
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Baldur. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf.
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillion. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past. And Dillion, her future.
Why didn't two realities. You have no time for this. Tearing at her soul. What if these trials mean nothing? Gods can see laughing at you. What if they take you back closer to Dillion? Dillion, you're letting this get in the way. What if they are just to tire you out, make you weak before the battle? He was the only one that really loved her. He did love her.
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur, weep him out of Hel. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they found in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise.
Look what happens to the things you love. Your love because he believed in you. He was the only one that didn't mind the curse.
He loved her so much. Is pointless. What are you doing?
The trial is pointless, and there's another way.
Why did you think you could make this work?
You keep seeing
runes. You see runes everywhere.
Everywhere.
But what if they're not real? What if they don't actually make sense?
The gods will lie there to be dead.
If you just think it makes sense, but really the gods are playing with you.
It makes sense in your mind, but it doesn't make sense.
Worlds.
The gods. But it doesn't mean anything.
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Baldur. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her reins. She pushes Baldur's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Baldur's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief and she dies. She's put next to her husband and the pyre is lit, sending the dead to hell. But even so, the gods cannot accept his death.
Does it feel warm? Do you feel safe?
Tilion loves you. He was kind to her.
What if they're all about wasting your time just delaying minute by minute by minute?
What does she think she's doing? You're special.
She was she worth it?
They mean nothing.
It wouldn't be this.
It would be the first time.
Tilion!
Be quick.
Tilion never much cared for the underworld and looked dimly upon the druids like her father, Zinmel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see, and he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, glad to see the world through his eyes. And slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
Be quick. Be quick. Be careful. Don't go down.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world thing? You, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price you pay for the gift you have? A gift that makes you so special in my eyes. Just another part of the person I know.
I left for the wilds to protect you from my darkness. Because I love you. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
Killing you would be too easy.
They're taking your memories to torture you.
They're taking you from the inside.
You're disappearing one memory at a time. Every time you remember, it disappears.
They're going to take everything.
They're not yours anymore.
They're going to take everything you have.
The memories of ghosts.
They belong to the gods, not to you.
They're eating you from the inside. They want to kill your soul.
They want to crush it.
You think they want your body, they want your soul.
They want your mind, and they're going to take it.
The memories were yours, but they're the gods now.
Nothing is yours anymore.
Dillian's disappearing with your memories.
Northmen say that their Allfather, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Can you hear me?
Dillian.
I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
The others. The voices. They've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Feel it rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
I can't go on. Lillian?
Find a way. I'm not leaving you here.
think I'm somewhere else now. The breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Go to it.
I've reached the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Senor, my father, he taught me that the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the sword. You're no coward. You proved that to me in warrior trials. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your battle. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. We need you like you.
Okay. I'll do my best.
Seems there's no escaping the past in this place. And so she's forced to relive it. To what end?
There is a house.
See it?
No.
Then it cannot see you. Quietly move past it, one step at a time.
Not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards.
Thank you. It stings. Of death.
The darkness is testing you. You are in control.
There's a well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Delia. Help me.
Yes, I can see you too.
She could spend hours, days even. Trapped within herself, in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere, with no memory of how she got there.
Comes for me. I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
Reforged, you will have Odin's blessing to walk a goddess into the halls of Helheim and challenge Hela as an equal.
So Dillion was helping me. And a sword will lead me to him. Like when we first met.
Dillion gave her the strength to pass the warrior trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind, and become a warrior in Dillion's clan.
Go back. The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
Years later, with Zinbel's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance.
Talia?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
The suffering you've caused.
This is your fault. You brought this plague to us. You have blood on your hands.
They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
They're coming to get to you.
Your heavy strike.
Hold it.
Hold the heavy strike.
Hold your heavy strike.
Unleash the sword.
Must remember, she can focus.
It's inside her. The mirror.
The corpse waved through itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone is sacred. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed minds.